So students, next we have short answer questions. So let's see what can be the answers of these questions. The first question is, what conditions are necessary for transfer of heat from one body to another by conduction? So if the flow of heat is done by the conduction, then what is the necessary condition? So let's see. So here are the conditions. The first one is, the two objects are in contact, so link should be must. If two objects are in contact with each other, then the conduction can be possible. And the another one, their temperatures are not same. That means if both the objects are hot, that means they would not get conduction, they would not show any change. Okay, so if the one object is hot and the another one is cold, then we can say this cold then turns into hot. Okay, so this can be the conduction. The next question, differentiate between good and bad conductors of heat. So let's see, what do you understand by the good conductor of heat and the bad conductor of heat? So the answer can be, materials which allow heat to be conducted through them easily are called good conductors of heat. So the objects or substances that are able to pass the heat from itself, that is known as good conductors of heat. And the another one, materials which do not allow heat to be conducted through them easily, they are called bad conductors of heat or insulators of heat. Okay, so bad conductors or insulators, so both the terms can be used for these kind of materials. Clear? And examples of good conductor of electricity can be iron, copper, silver. And in the other hand, insulators can be wood, plastic and glass. The next question we have, why do woolen clothes keep us warmer in winters than cotton clothes? So basically, these woolen clothes, they act as an insulator. Why? Because they have some space between them. So if the space is there, that means the conduction or the connection between two things will be less. And if the conduction will be less, that means it can be the bad conductor of heat. So hence we wear woolen clothes in winter season. Now move to our next question. Why are ventilators in houses provided at the top of the walls? So students, ventilators are set up high on the walls. Why? Because the gas which we breathe out, it is warmer and lighter, and then it directly rises up, right? And this warm air escapes from the ventilators, and this hot air, it goes upward. Okay, and makes our room or our surrounding cool by the convection method. Got it? So let's see our next question. How does heat from the sun reach us? At what speed does this transfer of heat take place? So student, here is our answer. The heat from the sun reaches us through millions of miles of empty space by radiation only. So in the form of UV rays, these reach us and takes approximately 8 minutes 20 seconds to reach on the earth. The next one we have, what is the function of the polished curved surface at the back of the heating rod in a room heater? So let's see what is the function of this polished surface. So students, this is the surface, that the polished surface in the room heater, and this surface, it reflects almost all the radiant heat. Okay, radiant heat, that means thermal heat. Okay, and when this is reflected by this plate, that means it will spread out. Got it? And by this, the heat, it spreads in the whole room. Okay, and it makes the room warmer quickly. So students, next we have long answer questions. The first one, explain how heat is conducted from the heated end of the rod to its cold end. So how does it go from the hot end to the cold end? So let's see. So students, let's see that how the heat transmits from one end to the another end. So first of all, what you need to do, you need to take a stand with fixing a rod in it, okay, and just below the rod you need to put a candle, okay, and then you need to take some thumb backs, okay, and even the thumb pins, and fix these thumb pins on the rod with the help of some wax, and then burn the candle. What would you see? That this end, it is just heating up with the help of candle, okay, but this heat, it goes from this point to this. So how can you show that this heat goes from this end to the this end? So here thumb backs were fixed, okay, but when this rod, it heats up, and the molecules that are heated up, they just starts moving in a whole rod, okay, and with this the thumb backs, they are just falling down one by one when the area of the rod starts burning, okay. So in the segments of this, the thumb backs started falling down, clear. So this is how you can say that this end heats up and the molecules transfer from one end to the another end. Last end also heats up, okay. Look at the second question. With an example of each, explain the uses of good and bad conductors of heat. So here we need to give some uses of this good conductor and bad conductor. So let's see. So here we have uses of good and bad conductors of heat. So first of all, we have good conductors. So basically these good conductor of heat are used in making of cooking utensils, clear. And brass and aluminium, these are very common for making these kind of utensils. Silver and copper can also be used for the cooking utensils, but they are a bit expensive, so we do not use these. The next we have bad conductors of heat. So students, what is the use of these bad conductors of heat? So they are basically used as the handles of cooking utensils, okay, because they just reduce the conduction between the metal, that means the cooking utensil, okay, and the handle of that, so that we can grip it well, right? So these are the examples of bad conductor of heat, like wood and plastic. So the next question we have, described the process of convection of heat. So let's see what is convection. First of all, let's understand that what convection is. It is the process of transfer of heat in which the heated molecules of a liquid themselves move to carry heat from the hot to the cold region. Okay, so this convection, it occurs in liquid and gas. I mean, between both, one can be there for the convection. So let's see how this convection can take place. So first of all, what we need to do? First of all, take a test tube, right, and fill with the cold water and drop an ice cube in the water, okay, and now heat this water from below, okay. So here from below you are starting heat it, okay, and you will find that ice melts quickly. When the water gets heated up, this water, it goes upward, okay, because the circulation will start, because the colder water, it is heavier than the hotter, okay, and then it comes down, okay, and the hot water goes upward, and with this ice starts melting easily. So students, let's move to our next question, that is, explain with the help of diagrams how sea and land breezes are set up. So let's see. So here are our both the pictures. Basic difference between both the picture is the sun and the moon. That means it occurs during the daytime and it occurs during the nighttime. So what happens in both the case? So first of all, let's talk about the sea breeze. So during the day, land heats up more than the water, and the air over the land becomes hotter and lighter and rises up, and the air from the sun, which is cooler and heavier, rushes to the take the place created by hot rising air, and therefore a sea breeze blows during the daytime. And if we move to the next picture, that is of land breeze, so during the night land loses heat faster than the water. In both the cases, land and water, both they lose their heat. But the thing is, in this case, water loses its heat faster, but in the case of land breeze, here land loses heat faster than the water and then becomes cooler, and the air over the sea is now warmer and it rises up, and cooler air over the land rushes to take its place. So thus we observe a land breeze at night. So this was the basic difference between both. Let's check the another question. Black objects absorb more heat than white or polished ones. Give two daily uses of this principle. So basically, dark colored objects absorb and radiate more heat than the light colored objects. Okay, so let's see what can be the two basic uses of this concept. So we wear white or light colored clothes in summer as they absorb less radiant heat and keep our body cooler. And the dark colored clothes are suitable in winter as they absorb more heat. So why this happened? The black color, it absorb maximum color in the vapor, and the cause of this we just if we talk about the light colored clothes like white and light blue, so these are the colors that reflect so many colors. Okay, and this is the basic reason behind this. Even the outer base of cooking utensil is painted black so that it absorbs more heat so that cooking can be done in less time. And next, the back of refrigerators are also colored dull black to radiate heat more effectively in order to cool down the refrigerator pipes. And the last one, electric hot plates are also colored dull black to radiate maximum heat. The next one we have, black objects radiate more heat than white objects. Give two everyday uses of this principle. So this is also quite similar, even the same answer you can write for this also, because in both the question concept is same, that is of radiant heat. Okay, so that means if radiation of heat will be more, that means the absorption will be also more. Now move to our next question, that is, draw a neat labeled diagram of a thermos flask. How does it prevent transfer of heat by conduction, convection or radiation? So here is the diagram of thermos flask. So like, this is a stopper with having a rubber seal with it, and this is double walled glass vessel, and this double walled glass vessel, it just reduces the flow of heat by convection and conduction. Okay, and this silvered wall, this just reflects the heat away, and cause of this, the conduction, convection and radiation, so all these three come zero here, and cause of this, the temperature would not change in the thermos flask. The last question of this chapter is, two test tubes full of water are heated, one from below and the another one from the near the top. In which case will the water heat up faster and why? Now look at the picture carefully. Test tube which is heated from below will heat up faster. When we heat water from below, the molecules at the bottom of water start heating and expanding, due to which they become light and move upwards. Okay, so this can be the right answer. So students, here our chapter completes, and in the next video we will come with our next chapter.